Hey everybody, this is Latonya Wilson, and I was coming to show you my daughter's box braids. I just finished doing them, and I want to show you how to seal the box braids with hot water. This is the hot water method, and I'm going to tell you some do's and don'ts while I'm at it. This is a cup. This cup I highly recommend because you can put a lot of hot water in it, and it will not melt or anything. But the don't I want to mention was, you see what I did? I let her hair drop a little bit before I got it all in the towel. Now, if you have a client, this is my daughter, but still, if you have a client, you need to have at least two towels. Put one towel across their back and have one towel so you can catch all of that heat from that hair, from that hot water, because it's very, very hot. I actually boiled this water on the stove, but thank God that she was far enough that when it bounced, the hair bounced down, it did not hurt her in any kind of a way. But learn from my mistake. Do not let that hair go unless it's all in that towel, because that steam is terrible. But here I am again. I'm moving down the hair. And that's actually the right method to move down the hair, okay? And you make sure you squeeze all that water out, all of it, every last bit that you can squeeze out. And after this is said and done, knowing me, I probably will blow dry it because she's going to be going to bed soon. So I just want to put this video up first. And then I'll probably go back and blow dry it also. And that also helps the hair not unravel while she's asleep. Right about now, if she wraps her hair, she's in a little bit of discomfort because it is tight. So if she wants to just put a little bonnet on and go to sleep, then she can. And she doesn't have to worry about anything getting wet. And here I am. I'm going to like the very ends again. I divided her hair into sections because this is synthetic hair. It's not human hair. And synthetic hair is much thicker than human hair. So I divided it into sections. And by me dividing into sections, that made it straighter. And then, as you can see, I'm going all the way down again with the towel, making sure that her hair is not dripping on her. It can drip all over the carpet. I don't care about that. I can clean that up as long as it doesn't drip on her. And especially if you were doing a client's hair. If I was doing a client's hair, I would never do this sloppy job that I'm doing right here. I'm just doing it fast. But for caution's sake, even though this is my daughter, the next time I do it, I'm going to make sure I have enough towels and everything. But this is the method that I've learned years ago. This straightens out the hair. And you can also use the same method. All you have to do is braid the hair on the ends. And you can also dip the hair, and it will crinkle the hair at the ends. And that's another method that I learned years ago. So this is nothing new. It's a very, very old method, but it's very good for human or synthetic hair to make it lay down, and it calms it where the hair is frizzy and bushy. It calms it down a whole lot. But that hair that water has to be very, very hot. So anyway, you guys, this is all I have. And I really appreciate you watching. And I have some pics at the end, so stay tuned and see exactly how it looks. Thank you, guys. Love y'all.